नमस्ते टू ऑल रेस्पेक्टेड वाइस चांसलर, रजिस्ट्रार, डीन्स, फैकल्टी मेंबर्स एंड माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स एंड पार्टिसिपेंट्स. इट गिव्स मी एन इमेंस प्लेजर टू बी अ रिसोर्स पर्सन ड्यूरिंग दिस इंटरनेशनल वेबिनार ऑन एविडेंस बेस्ड मॉडिफिकेशन थ्रू योगा in COVID-19 pandemic. Today's topic for discussion is psychophysiological changes in cyclic meditation. Cyclic meditation is Avartan Dhyan. We will be more discussing about the science of meditation in this session. Myself, Dr. Subramanya Pailur from Central University of Kerala, Kasaragod. The overview of my talk is I'll be discussing something about the basic fundamental idea about yoga, the concept of cyclic meditation, the practice of cyclic meditation, and there have been good number of research publications and research findings of cyclic meditation, basic concept of stress, research findings of general other meditation techniques, and conclusion. To begin, we will understand, and we all know that, what is yoga? An ancient Indian scientific way of life directed at all levels, like promoting health at physical, mental, social, and spiritual planes of human existence, in line with the definition of the World Health Organization to attain total health. It says that it is not mere absence of disease, it is totality what we gain. Holistic approach is discussed. According to Patanjali Yoga Sutra, Yoga Chitta Vritti Nirodha is yoga. Yoga is the process of gaining mastery over mental modifications. According to Bhagavad Gita, Samatvam Yoga Uchyate, that is, equilibrium. Yoga is equilibrium, which brings equanimity, stability, equipoise, balance, harmony within the practitioner. According to Yoga Karmasu, according to Yoga Vasishta, Manah Prashamana Upayah Yoga Ityabhidhiyate, skill to calm down the mind is yoga. Manaha prashamana, the calming down of the mind, is yoga. According to Bhagavad Gita, yoga karmasu kaushalam, skill in action, is yoga. Yoga comes from the root word yuj, which means union. Meditation is a state in which there is reasoning, reflection, bliss, and a pure sense of human being. According to Patanjali, the seventh limb of Ashtanga Yoga is Dhyana, the meditation. After the purification methods, Yama, Niyama, then we practice Asana, Pranayama, Pratyahara as Bahiranga Yoga. Then move on to Antaranga Yoga, that is Dharana, Dhyana, Samadhi. In this, we will be more discussing about dhyana. So the meditative transformation is the simultaneous reduction of distractions and enhanced focused awareness within us. However, not everyone can meditate to begin with. Many people find it difficult to relax and get into a meditative state if asked to sit with their eyes closed, while others feel drowsy and even fall asleep. This technique, called cyclic meditation, was devised from S. Vasa Yoga University by Dr. H. R. Nagendra G. Meditation here, the meditation interspersed with physical postures. this concept is wherein combination of postures and relaxation, which reduces physiological arousal when it compared with the normal supine rest position, and also enhances the ability to focus and shift the attention. In cyclic meditation, it is rest with sustained and selective attention. What is cyclic meditation? The Avartan Dhyana. Cyclic meditation is a technique which combines stimulating and calming practices. Based on a statement in ancient yoga text suggesting that such a combination may be especially helpful to reach a state of mental equilibrium. Cyclic meditation was designed much earlier by Guruji, Dr. H.R. Nagendraji, and it is called as cycle, as the technique takes the practitioner through alternating cycles of asanas and guided relaxation in Shavasana. Being involved in specific practices keeps an overactive mind busy and also stops one from falling asleep. The concept is taken from well-known Upanishads called Mandukya Karika. It says that Laye Sambodaye Chittam Vikshiptam Shamayet Punaha Sakashayam Vijaniyat Samapraptam Nachalayet. In a state of mental oblivion, awaken the mind. When agitated, pacify it. In between, understand the mind is full of potency. If the mind has reached a state of equilibrium, perfect equilibrium, then do not disturb it again. It says, the Karika says, stimulate and awaken the sleeping mind. Calm down the distractions. Recognize the innate stagnations and stay in steadiness without disturbing that particular state. This is the particular meaning of sutta. In simple words, it is stimulation followed by relaxation. Stimulation, which breaks the all stagnations, and relaxation, which reduces the stress levels of an individual. The key feature of this cyclic meditation technique is stimulate and relax. Allow the relaxation to continue by deep internal awareness. This practice involves simple standing, balanced postures, asanas, lateral arc posture, forward bending, half-wheel posture, and shavasana, emphasizing breathing and feelings, like maintaining awareness throughout the practice. This practice starts with prayer. Keep your eyes closed. Remember to breathe slowly and rhythmically. Tune your awareness to the changes occurring in your body as you make slow and unhurried movements. Starts with Om chanting, then IRT, instant relaxation technique, then the standing postures like Tadasana, Ardhakati Chakrasana, Padahastasana, etc. Then QRT, quick relaxation technique. Then sitting postures like Vajrasana, Supta Vajrasana. Then deep relaxation technique. Altogether, the cyclic meditation technique is practiced for 23 minutes. These are some of the postures, physical postures, which commonly practiced in cyclic meditation. Stimulation and relaxation, sambodhana and prashamana, and continuous, unbroken and dispassionate awareness is maintained throughout the practice, which brings stabilizing in the effortless expansive meditative state is seen throughout the practice. There have been extensive research on cyclic meditation. The studies have been carried out from the psychological level to physiological, psychophysiological, and to the brain science, that is neuroscience, at the brain level. It was shown that a period of cyclic meditation significantly reduced the oxygen consumption by 32.1% when it compared with cyclic meditation, simple shavasana. And similar, another study also showed that similar result, that is 19.3% was reduction in oxygen consumption. Psychological variables like six-letter cancellation test showed that there was an increase in score by 24.9% following the cyclic meditation. The brain research that is on evoke potential and P300 showed that there was an increase in the amplitude, peak amplitude, and decrease in the peak latency. The autonomic variables like the sympathetic and parasympathetic activity also shown that was there was an increase in the parasympathetic activity, and which brought to a parasympathetic dominance and reducing the sympathetic activity, that is stress level has been reduced after the practice of cyclic meditation. And in the ratio of low frequency and high frequency, it also showed that there was a decrease in the heart rate following cyclic meditation. The performance of an individual was tested by a cancellation task and found that there was an increase in the performance which required selective attention, concentration, visual scanning abilities, and a repetitive motor response following cyclic meditation. The evoke potential studies, as I discussed earlier, is also shown that there was a decrease in the peak latency and increase in the peak amplitude following cyclic meditation. So it also showed that there was an improved memory scores immediately after the practice of cyclic meditation and decreased state anxiety, and the stress level was reduced after the practice. It was told in Bhagavad Gita that repeated thinking about objects leads to attachment, and attachment to desires, desires to anger, which leads to lack of awareness and discrimination, and one is completely lost in the day-to-day activities. Dhyayato vishayan pumsaha sangasteshu pajayate sangat sanjayate kamaha kamat krodho vijayate krodhat bhavati sammoha sammoha smriti vibramaha smriti vibramshat buddhinashaha buddhinashat pranashyate. It distracts, mental illness distracts all the activities of human life. It is also told that who is able to stand the rush and lust of anger in this very life is accomplished and alone is a happy person. Now we have to understand, according to Patanjali Yoga Sutra, what are the causes of pain? That is lack of knowledge, I-ness, strong likes and dislikes, the fear of death. Avidya, asmita, raga, dvesha, abhinishvesha are kleshas. These are stress-producing factors we can call. How the mechanism takes place, facilitates the balance between sympathetic and parasympathetic divisions of autonomic nervous system through cyclic meditation, reduces somatic motor tone, effects on hormones and neurotransmitters. What are the advantages and disadvantages of this practice? It improves general health, and no external agent is needed, no side effects of interactions. What are the disadvantages? It requires participation, complete involvement, awareness should be maintained throughout the practice. These are some of the concepts discussed earlier. Overall, to say that meditation brings a state of alert rest, sensory perception is enhanced and more accurate, and physiological arousal is decreased. These are some of the findings of cyclic meditation, cycles of stimulation and deep rest. These are the publications in different journals and by using different parameters. Summarized in this slide. There have been extensive research has been carried out with other meditation techniques as well, like transcendental meditation, Brahma Kumaris, Raja Yoga meditation, Vipassana meditation, cyclic meditation, and meditation on Om. In summary, to say that through the practice, one can calm down his mind. As the mind gets calm, so does the breath, and then the body is in a state of balance and homeostasis. To conclude, I say that according to B.K.S. Iyengar, yoga does not just change the way we see things, it transforms the person who sees. Thank you for your patient hearing. I am in depth grateful to Professor Dr. Samiran Mandal, the Dean, Physical Education and Sports Laboratory, and also the head of the Department of Yogic Art and Science Department. And thanks for giving me an opportunity to present this paper. And once again, I am thankful to Vishwabharati Central University for giving me an opportunity and conducting this international webinar during this pandemic situation. Thank you. Thank you, Vandana.